All right, hello everybody. All right, the time is now 5:28 p.m. It's 7:05:20, and I'm gonna post a bunch of pictures and some videos. This is really about two things: one, the storm that we just got today, and the Gold Eyes and the Red Hawks. I'm not gonna tell you who won, but you will tell by what I'm gonna show you. All right, about the thunderstorm that started here today in the city around 3:30. I'm going to show you guys a picture, and then I'll do the video. And this, I'll show you this. First of all, this is what seemed to have started earlier. Check this out. Okay. That was about 3:30. Okay. There's more of it. Now that's a little after the storm, but look how dark, like, you tell me, what does that look like right there? Where are we? Right there. That looks pretty swirly, huh? Now, I'm going to show you guys this. I apologize for the way I took the video, because I had my cross on, but the thing kept switching back and forth on me. You tell me, does that look like a funnel cloud? Look at this. Hang on, right there. See it, guys? That sure looks like a funnel, a tornado, doesn't it? Now, I'm going to check to see. Now, I'm going to play the video. Now, this is after. This is about, again, about 5 minutes after. See right in the middle there? That's what's left of it. I'm telling you guys, that was a funnel cloud. That was a tornado. Now, I'm going to do the video of this. All right, guys. It's exactly 4 o'clock p.m. here on Sunday, July 5th, 2020.
There was just a tornado spotted.
I believe there was a funnel cloud. See where the inn sign is? Just to the left of that, between that and the tree? That would be around Assiniboia Downs. I think there was a funnel cloud. I'll post a picture of it after. But it looked like a funnel cloud. And I think it hit the ground because you could see the dust up. So it looks like there was a tornado. And we'll see. That was at 3:52, about 8 minutes ago. Let's see if they say anything about it on the news later. If it is, then we caught you. And you're the one who noticed it, so you just see. If it is, you just seen your first tornado. I've seen a few in the years past, but nothing since we've been here. That's pretty wicked. So, guys, I think that was a tornado hit the ground around Assiniboia Downs. Maybe a little further out than that, but it was out that way. But that was pretty... That's pretty crazy. That was at 3:52 p.m. today. Now, this has to do with the Gold Eyes. All right, guys. In baseball, the Gold Eyes are up 7-6 and going to the bottom of the top 8. Just ended going bottom 8. Gold Eyes were down 4-0, and they made it 7-4, now 7-6. Starting to rain a little bit. It's, what, 4:05 p.m.? But, yeah, it looks pretty freaking dark. Got a little bit of thunder activity ahead of us, above us. So we'll see what happens. But go Fish. They won 15-1 last night. It was a hell of a game to listen to. But, yep, right there, guys. I think that was a tornado. That, in fact, funnel cloud, it was, hit the ground. Because you can see the dust coming up. So someone got torn apart somewhere. Alright, guys, game is 7-6. Gold Eyes going bottom 9. I got a feeling the Fish are going to lose this game. It's pretty dark again out in the east. Getting rained on like nobody's business. But anyway, we'll see what happens here. Go Fish, but I think they're going to lose. Alright, check this out. Bottom 9. There's already a man on. It's 3-1 to the batter. Want to bet he walks him? Another ninth inning heroics here. This is, I can't stand Forney. This guy's, something seriously wrong with the guy. Watch this, he'll get on, watch. 3-1 to the batter. just waiting for it. We walked him. He walked him 2-1. Oh, man. Forney needs to go. All right, get this one. Hit by a pitch, bases loaded, none out, bottom nine. More heroics. All right, Rick Forney is a total loser. They just walked one in. Look at this. Bases were loaded. They walked him in. They have this guy by the name of Rao. Like, he's playing like crap now in the ninth. Keep him in, though, right? Can you believe this? Bases are still loaded with none out. I told you the Gold Eyes were going to lose this game. Rick Forney, 15 years. Out the door. They got to get rid of this guy because they're not winning a damn thing with this guy at the helm. What a disgrace. So next video I do will be game over for the Fish. Alrighty, guys. You watch. Now it's a full count with one out. Now watch. This idiot Rao. I'm guessing R-H-E-A-U-L-T or Ralt. It's obviously a French name, so it's probably Rao or Rao or something. But watch this. Bases are loaded. One out. Full count. He'll walk in the winning run. You just watch what he'll do right here. Oh, I tell you what. Fish were down 4-0. They were up 7-4. Now it's tied. They're going to lose. They won two games. The first two games. Why would Forney go and screw with the lineup? Why would you do that? So this can happen. That's why. Forney's a saboteur. They need to get rid of the man. Because he's no good for this club. You're never going to win a damn thing. You're never going to have anything consistent or to feel good that you're going to win because of the guy. He just doesn't get it. They got rid of that Tom Vaith. I'm glad he's gone. Here it comes. Oh my God, they got the double play. Oh my God. Going to extra innings tied at 7. The double play. Well, if the Fish get nothing in top of 10, they're done in bottom 10. Alright, Fish screwed the pooch top of 10. You can see right here. We're going to bottom 10, 7-7. This is going to be the walk-off for Fargo. I guarantee it. Alright guys, the Gold Eyes get out of bottom 10. Again, they turn the double play, and we're going to the 11th inning, still tied at 7. Not just that, you look around, that storm has moved out. It's nice and clear. Still a little dark in the east. But for the most part, that thunderstorm, there were tornadoes spotted in a place called Altona and whatnot, and that's what came this way, was that cell. And like I said, just out there, you'll see the picture after. Right between there, you'll see what looked like a funnel cloud. And just by watching it in real time, it looked like it hit the ground, and you can see it, some dust up. So I think there was something happening. Anyways, hopefully the Gold Eyes pulled this off. Sorry about the cough, guys.
All right, it's 5:02 p.m., and top 11 is over. Going bottom 11, still tied at 7. The Gold Eyes just keep tempting fate, and I think they're about to meet theirs right now.
And this will tell you.
Oh, I think me thinks just saw Planet Boy. It looks like a cooping we went.
Make Little Bits Butthurt report.
Well, I told you guys it's game over. I told you they were going to win it. Fargo wins 8-7 in 11 innings. I told you that's the way it was going to go down. So the Fish flounder for the third game. Way to go, Forney, for being a moron and changing things up. This guy's got to go 15 years. It's over, guys. It's over. 16 league this year. If you can't win a championship, we got problems. But anyway, that is it.
Okay, guys, so that is it for videos. As you just heard, the Gold Eyes lost 8-7. They're now 2-1 on the season. Friday, a 9-5 win. 15-1 last night. Why is a field manager? Why is Forney? Why would you go out and make all these field on the field changes for this game? If it was working, why screw with it? That doesn't make any damn sense to me. But they lose. Looks like there was a tornado. I'm telling you it was. If not, it was a funnel cloud. If not, then you tell me what that was. Then it was forming. But that was pretty crazy. I guess that's it, guys. And adios amigos.